Hello, everyone. Imagine this. You speak into or record a conversation onto your iPhone. You save the audio capture, and a few minutes later, those words bloom on your SuperNote as real editable pen strokes when you wirelessly sync the device. But how is that even possible? Let's look under the hood what we have in place to make this workflow a breeze. On the iPhone, we are leveraging Microsoft Word's excellent dictation feature for having audio and dictation transcripts saved on OneDrive. More specifically, we are saving the .docx file in a particular folder of OneDrive SuperNote sync folders. On the computer, OneDrive Synchronizer creates a mirrored local folder of SuperNote sync file architecture. The task scheduler periodically runs Python on the mirrored folder. New files found in a particular subfolder trigger Python.x to pen strokes conversion feature and notebooks are created. OneDrive Synchronizer automatically uploads on the cloud the notebooks created by Python. On SuperNote, when we synchronize, the newly created notebooks are transferred. So for this specific workflow, we're going to need an iPhone, the Microsoft Word app, OneDrive as a cloud synchronization service on the SuperNote, and a Windows task scheduler periodically running Python on a PC. Let's illustrate this with two examples. But before we proceed, take a second to subscribe and hit the notification bell for further updates. It helps me assessing the interest for these videos. I have no sponsors and make absolutely zero money with these. Don't you worry. All right. In the first example, we'll use the iPhone Word app to simply listen to a conversation or a lecture. In the second example, we're going to really dictate something using basic formatting vocal commands. You ready? Let's first proceed with the one-time workflow preparation. As we said before, we intend to use the Word app on our phone and use speech input through the microphone. Once we are done capturing the audio in Word, we save the document in a particular folder dedicated for the SuperNote on OneDrive. By particular, I mean a folder whose path contains a special string instructing Python to convert .docx files to the notebook format. By default, the special string is text2notes. Now, how do we get the file to Python? One fast and efficient way would be accessing OneDrive contents programmatically using Microsoft Graph API. But we want a more general recipe, so instead, we are just going to rely on OneDrive Synchronizer running on the computer. That routine runs in the background to populate a local mirrored file architecture, and we're going to configure Python to process that local folder. So we need a few Python settings. First, we're going to tell Python not to waste time locating for a wired or browse and access connection by setting the cloud parameter to true. Second, we are also going to ensure that the syncf parameter has the path of our OneDrive mirrored files. Third, we want our transcript to appear in a certain font. Here I chose the caveat font family. Now we also want to automate this process by configuring Windows Task Scheduler to periodically run Python. If you're on Mac OS, you'll want to configure Launchd. If you're on Linux, you want to configure cron. What follows is specific for Windows. You can take a look at my XML configuration under the Windows Task Scheduler folder on GitLab. You probably won't be able to import as is, but at least you can export your file and compare to troubleshoot. A quick overview. First, you can see that I chose to run the task only when I'm logged on. Second, I checked the hidden box because I just want the script to run without interaction. Third, Windows Task Scheduler is an old program, and the highest configuration I can choose on this drop-down is Windows 10. Let's look at the Triggers tab. This is a one-time task starting on June 10th at 8 a.m. local time. But you can see under Advanced Settings that it repeats itself every 4 minutes for a period of 100 days, and that it is enabled. Please save energy and change these settings to a more reasonable frequency. 4 minutes was for demo and testing purposes. On to the Actions tab. The first action is about Python. Let me copy and paste the settings in a notepad for you to see what I have in the Program Script field. Important to note that we are using Python WEXE, not simply Python, So the W is critical to avoid a terminal being opened whenever the script runs. In the add argument input field, it's simply digest.py. And for start in, you need to provide the path to your Python install folder. Now, I also added another action to restart the OneDrive synchronizer. And again, this is because I am impatient. A restart somehow forces OneDrive to look at changes. You don't really need it, assuming that most Windows users have OneDrive synchronizer is running all time in the background. But if you really want to duplicate my settings, you'll have to fill WS script under program script and the path to a VB script. I am showing the content of the OneDrive restart here, but it's also going to be posted on GitLab. All right, to summarize our configuration for this demo, every 4 minutes the task scheduler runs Python. More specifically, we are interested in using Python's text-to-pen stroke conversion that takes a text, Word doc, or Markdown file as input to generate a notebook in the same folder if the folder path contains a special string, by default, text2sn. I'm going to play a video and let the Word app just listen to the conversation. Let me first make sure that I switch the auto punctuation mode.
Eric Schmidt, thank you for joining us.
Thank you.
Let's go back. You said the arrival of non-human intelligence is a very big deal. And this photo taken in 2016 feels like one of those quiet moments where the Earth shifted beneath us, but not everyone noticed. What did you see back then that the rest of us might have missed?
In 2016, we didn't understand what was now going to happen, but we understood that these algorithms were new and powerful. What happened in this particular set of games was in roughly the second game, there was a new move invented by AI in a game that had been around for 2,500 years.
That no one you can see seen. That the transcription takes place in real time. I don't have the most recent iPhone. I think we're already at phone 16, and this is an iPhone 13, but it's decent.
Greater than 50% chance of winning. And so it calculated correctly this move, which was this great mystery among all of the Go players, who are obviously insanely brilliant mathematical and intuitive players. The question that Henry, Craig Mundy, and I started to discuss, right, is what does this mean? How is it that our computers could come up with something that humans had never thought about? I mean, this is a game played by billions of people. And that began the process that led to two books, and I think, frankly, is the point at which the revolution really started.
If you fast forward to today, it seems that all anyone can talk about is AI, especially here at TED, but you've taken a contrarian stance. You actually think AI is underhyped. Why is that?
And I'll tell you why. Most of you think of AI as, I'll just use the general term, as ChatGPT. For most of you, ChatGPT was the moment where you said, oh my God, this thing writes, and it makes mistakes, but it's so brilliantly verbal, right? That was certainly my reaction. Most people that I knew did that.
It was visceral, yeah.
This was 2 years ago. Since then, the gains in...
Okay, I think this is enough for the audio capture. My iPhone is just sitting on the table while I play that YouTube video. And there are a few mistakes, but it's pretty good. Probably both due to the iPhone excellent speech-to-text engine and the word interpretation of pauses and context to insert punctuation.
Extraordinary.
Let's fast forward. Let me stop the microphone and save the file in the text2notes folder. Again, this is a special folder that Python will use as source to convert docx files. We can see that the docx file is immediately on the cloud. After a while, OneDrive Synchronizer creates the mirrored file locally. And then Python detects the new Word file and creates a notebook. Let's synchronize the supernote. There is only the Word document. After a while, OneDrive Synchronizer detects the new notebook and uploads it from the computer to the cloud. All checks are there. We can now manually synchronize the supernote, and voila! We have a new notebook with the transcript of the TED Talk. I don't need to be at my desk. All I need is to synchronize the supernote at one point, and I know I will get a notebook from the audio. If you are familiar with Python, you know that the text is reflowed over several pages. The pen strokes are fully editable and are recognized by the text recognition engine. In the second example, I'm going to use some formatting voice commands. I'm also going to use a basic Word template. It will give you an idea about what can be accomplished if you need some pre-formatting. The cool thing with the template is that I already have the headers ready. But I could also use some other formatting, like using the word bold. Okay, this time, instead of just clicking the plus button, we're going to choose the fourth template. Click on the mobile view to make this legible. I'm going to select the various fields and then dictate. On my small screen, this is not the easiest way to create a document. So let me fast forward. Let's save the Word document, wait a bit, and open the notebook on the SuperNote. Right out of the bat, I can tell that the formatting isn't what I expected, probably because Python's style interpreter didn't like extra spaces. So let's open the Word file on the computer to edit it. By the way, remember the overall workflow? These arrows indicate that modifying the Word file from anywhere will result in a subsequent notebook being created by Python. Note also that when we open the notebook and recycle the placeholder, we are modifying the note file, and modifying a file in two different places will lead to some conflicts. Just be aware of this. It's actually a good thing that OneDrive doesn't overwrite some changes that we may have made intentionally in the notebook. So let me change a bit the header styles, setting some to heading 2, save a weight a bit, and voila, a better formatted notebook with pseudo headers appearing in the table of contents. All right, folks, I hope some will find this specific workflow useful, or that it will inspire others to create variants using different devices, platforms, with or without additional external steps, such as AI to summarize the speech before the conversion to the notebook format, etc. I had this draft video for more than a week, and since then I came up with other variants, most of them using shortcuts in iOS, Dropbox, and sometimes GPT to break the capture into section with pseudo headings. These recipes are also on GitLab, and I have a few short demo videos on this channel. Please share your own variants or any thoughts in the comments below, and in the meantime, happy writing!